Arizona is the place that can help us have that entire lab to fab ecosystem.
We're definitely looking at probably hundreds to thousands of new jobs, billions of dollars in new investments.
I think people will look back at this date and say, that's when things really started to move.
We are the first group that demonstrated in people that if you change the microbiome, you have these behavioral benefits in children with autism. We saw that after treatment, many of these children that we treated are not even in the category of autism when they get evaluated anymore.
What we do with bacteria in space is try to use the microgravity environment of spaceflight to unveil novel clues in terms of how the bacteria are causing disease in our body.
We actually invented this technology here. This is a protein microarray. It's a glass chip, and the idea was to take the blood from patients with cancer, put them on this array, and see which proteins they stuck to. In the end, we identified a couple of dozen different markers specific for cancer.
So what we found is that the cancer cells that are most mutated, that are most altered, that are most aggressive, are also the ones that are most visible to T cells. So now we can sequence those tumors. We can identify the changes in the cancer cells. We can develop vaccines and T cell immune therapies to try to target the very changes that are happening within those tumors.
Companies and outside organizations like to partner with ASU because we're easy to work with, we're agile, we listen. I think we take pride in understanding problems that need to be solved.
I moved up to store manager and I enrolled in the college achievement program and I was like, I can do school and have a degree and have a career debt-free.
They offer coaching, support, and guidance to entrepreneurs and innovators who have a business idea and don't know how to take that idea into fruition.
We're really trying to focus on how do we keep people safe while they're online. One way is actually trying to tackle that super high value vulnerability marketplace. And the idea being, how do we find those really important, impactful vulnerabilities before bad guys are able to do it?
As we study the flaws of chemistry, we also discover there are chemicals that are man-made and that are more risky than the naturally occurring ones. On September 2nd of 2016, the United States Food and Drug Administration announced a ban of triclosan, triclocarban, and many other antimicrobial chemicals.
We're taking would-be waste plastics. They actually come in and land right where I am on this floor before they go into the system. Before they leave this one building, they are a brand new product. We do the work. We don't just talk about it or theorize about it. We get our hands dirty doing it.
Arizona State University is committed to research that drives innovation. This helps power our economy, our workforce, and future growth.